So now we will move on to another kind of community center, the Impact Hub in Athens. And it's not Elena, but Dimitris Kokkinakis, I think, is back. And you've already been with us, but now you are presenting the Impact Hub. And perhaps you can also come in on some of the issues which you actually wanted to raise before. But thank you for taking over. And you're already sharing your screen and already, I think, tuned in. So over to you.
Yes, thank you, everyone. Thank you for having me and having the Impact Hub here, representing our work. Thank you for all the speakers previously. Like, I think it's enormous knowledge that is already out there, and it's already happening, like a transformation in terms of the civic, the cultural, and the economic scene, let's say, all together combined. I will tell you a little bit of my story. So I'm one of the co-founders and co-directors of the Impact Hub in Athens. I started in 2010, so I was part of the Impact Hub in Vienna, where I firstly joined, like, in order to see that we're talking about communities of change and how communities can drive positive solutions in urgent matters, sustainable entrepreneurial solutions. So I would like to see, and I wanted to see, how is this working. I was impressed from the network, and my colleague was part of the Impact Hub in Madrid. We came back in 2013 in Athens with the intention to start the Impact Hub there. So let me change the slide. Yes. So we are part of an international network. We are currently present in 105 cities around the world. We are an association, so this is also an interesting model of how in 2010 the Impact Hubs, that they were already part of a franchise model, we bought the brand and we turned out to be an association. So now we are a general assembly. Each Impact Hub owns one vote and one one place, let's say, in the general assembly, and we meet once per year to take decisions in terms of strategy, direction, and redefining our common visions, values, and revisiting our values, and designing the strategy further. So from social inclusion and social integration to environmental projects, we engage a long list of community people. So it's like experts, it's dreamers, it's creatives, it's tech people, innovators, in order to come up with solutions in topics that matters for the city, for Greece, and the globe. So we have, like, the code of ethics, as we say, of collective action and collaborative methodologies, and we engage with people in all the stages, from the intention, from the creation of awareness, into taking action, into up and running initiatives, and into scaling the initiatives further beyond. This is the three elements, the circle that we are using. So we are convening a community. We truly believe that the impact cannot happen in isolation, but we need to combine forces in order to move forward. So we bring together, like, in different forms, the community together, and from different backgrounds. So it's like the civic sector, is the social sector, the public sector, and the private sector. We design meaningful content, so we provide programming, events, festival settings, co-creation processes, in order to bring forward some topics and develop, like, further initiatives. And we provide spaces, we build spaces that they're mainly physical and virtual, or they're pop-up spaces where people, they can get inspired, they can connect, and they can also learn. You can see here, as I said, like, this is where we can find Impact Hubs at the moment. Our values, they are based on trust, collaboration, and courage. We believe that we need as individuals and as organizations to be more collaborative, to work closer together. We need to show trust that everyone is really taking forward the agenda or the intentions that they are claiming. And it needs courage, because the roads or the paths that we are deciding to blade or to move forward, they are new and they have a lot of difficulty. So it requires a lot of resilience and sometimes to be stubborn towards your goals. This is, as you can see, like part of our spaces. We got a building from the 1860 in the center of Athens. We transformed it into a place for events, like as a community center. It has a co-working space. We are hosting a comics library on the basement with a model that someone can pick up comics and they can work, they can return them after 15 days with the membership model. And it's also a learning space. So for example, in the comics library, we host workshops for refugee kids and mothers to learn the language through comics and through storytelling. So they create like their own comic, and it's like a language courses and a kid safe space, but also an educational center. On the upper floor is like the main space for our events, and also like an area like where people can meet and connect. We have a community kitchen, we have a common garden, different meeting rooms, and we had also a bike kitchen, so a place where you could also fix your bike. We started in 2013, as I mentioned before, and then in 2016 we acquired also two more buildings on the right. So at the moment we operate in 800 square meters in the center of Athens. So what we notice is that we need new tools to understand and craft new models. It is very important to understand that at the moment, like, everyone is called into a transition. We are in a system that is failing, and all the different sectors, they need to collaborate, they need to adjust, and we need to find like different models of working together. So that's why I would like to share and discuss further with you about the project of the municipal market of Kipseli. Let me just change my presentation. So this is an old story of a building that it used to be in an area that it was very developed. Then it had a big downgrade. It had like a change in the population, a lot of migrants mixing with local people. And it used to be also a more dangerous area for various reasons. And there was a historic building, a landmark building.
Dimitris, sorry, we can't see your presentation.
I think now, just a second. Now you can see. Oh, no, not yet, but now.
It's coming. Yes, that's fine. Thank you.
Great. So as you can see, this is the municipal market of Kipseli. We call it back to the hood. So this was an area that it had this landmark building, like more than 1,400 square meters. It used to be an old market with vegetables, with butcheries, with nuts and different retailers inside. And it used to be a very vivid space. But when the big supermarkets and like the whole market back in the 90s like changed into the malls, it started getting empty. And the building also started to be not sufficient anymore to hold any of activities. So back then there was a group of citizens that they managed to enter the building into the protected listed buildings, and it managed to protect it, so the area didn't turn out to be a parking. So they managed to protect the building. Then it was formed in somehow like a mix of a squat and a social center that it ran like different operations for a period of time. Then it got more political, let's say, more connected to political parties. And then in 2012, like the municipality came back the building, and with EU money, they managed to renovate it with 2 million euros. So they restructured it, but they wanted to have a different model of how to share this building and how to use this building further. Because of the money of the European Union, they couldn't claim it commercially. So for the next 5 years, they couldn't have profits out of this building. So they made like a study of how much it would cost to run it, like with municipality resources, and this was insufficient. So they made a more participatory process that was the first time actually tried out, like an open process for organizations or groups to run with content the municipal market of Kipseli by undertaking all the management and the running costs of the building. So this project didn't include any funding. It was an empty space, let's say. So the idea was that you don't have to pay rent, but you have to take all the costs of administration, running costs, repairing costs for the next 5 years. So the process was this one. We applied with Impact Hub Athens with our team, and we had like the vision to revitalize the municipal market of Kipseli by creating like an urban living room. So where people can connect from different cultures, and we could create a safe space for all with three basic elements of culture, education, and social economy. This started in 2016. So for a year we were studying and we're researching with the neighborhood, the current activities, and we were preparing our proposal to the municipality. And now we are in 2020, so I would give you a little bit of information about what is happening. In 2017, we started working towards like the prototype. So for a year, we were prototyping activities within the market to see also what is interesting for the people. We had like a lot of interviews, a lot of focus groups to understand what is viable and what it can fit as an activity like in this topography, so with this group of people. So we were working around the three elements of culture, education, and social innovative entrepreneurship. And we started running like different activities, having pop-up stores, and performances in a regular basis. So I will go pillar by pillar. We, in the pillar of education, we organized different activities. We had like open orchestra classes, like with orchestra instruments, but also we had like workshops with dance, photography, music, visual arts, but also modern technological tools like robotics, gamification, and language courses. So we were also hosting courses for refugees, like Greek and English classes every morning. So this could create also like a mixture of audience and representation within the market. Here you can see like some of the numbers, like this was for year one. We had we applied the STEAM methodology. So we had science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics classes. We were aiming like into young kids at the beginning. And the idea was that the kids could be also the glue between the parents in order to create a safe space for all. So people were coming like with an intention to have something good for their kids. So waiting for their kids outside from the class, they had already a common experience into a common space that this created also further connections down the line. So we had also, apart from the regular programming, different camps that it was like during Easter or during summer. We had concerts, so it's not only for learning, but the kids and all the classes, they have to perform once per month in the big space. That is also like the shops, the other vendors. Yes. So apart from this, we were working together with Caritas and Danish Refugee Council, that they were providing also financial services, legal advice, and the language courses to population that was in need, local or people that they had experienced exile. We were having the IT skills together with ELAC, that is a program called Code and Create. So it's based on open code, and we had like mixed the classes, like for kids to learn like web development and also robotics. And we had like for adults also photography lessons that they had to go around the neighborhood, and a theater group that was formed from the neighborhood also. Moving further, we worked with culture. Like this was also a big discussion among the team. Like we were having like different productions within the years. And there were a lot of different ethnicity groups and ethnicity organized communities in the neighborhood that we wanted to showcase, like in terms of culture, food, energy. And this was a good introduction, like of different cultures, like representing the neighborhood, but coming together around common elements, like a big table for food, or around music, or around more festive activities. So we were running the ethnofests. We have done the Ethiopian, Ukrainian, Georgian. We that did also a Greek panegyri, so like the Greek tradition of festivity. We had music jams that were inviting different musicians to come together and co-create music. We had the cinema girematta that was like theme screens parallel with cooking actions. That they were combining the culture with the food. And we had also like a residency house with of the neighborhood, and also Athenian Madolinata that they are creating open rehearsals within the common space. And also like we invite different organizations that they are like-minded to work together with us. So moving now to the third element, like we create a permanent and pop-up markets. We have 6 stores and 3 themed pop-up markets. I will move a little bit further so you can see. So our shops was White Greece, like it's local products and contribution to small producers. That is part of the profits, they are reinvested in the producers so they can gain, let's say, more income. We had like a repairing store, a secondhand store, a juice store, and a small gallery that they are working people with Down syndrome. And also like in the back spaces, there's the cultural space and the educational space. And the pop-up markets, we have like a pop-up branch that is like a food mecca. We have the Bostani that we invite very small producers from Attica to serve like vegetables, seasonable vegetables without like any toxic fertilizers. And we have also the Super Kipseli that is like one celebration of the neighborhood where we invite local shops to come to the pop-up market and set up their table. So just to, like, these are some numbers. Yes, because I need to wrap it up, I guess. How many minutes can I get?
3, 4.
4 5. Minutes? Okay. Yeah. So I will just give you like, these are some numbers, but you will see they updated as well in our report this year. So for us, like some important elements is the self-sufficiency of the program, of the project. So we didn't want only to be providers, you know, of services, but this is an open lab to understand how social centers and community centers, they can be as well self-sufficient. So how can we develop models that they can stand alone and they don't need, let's say, big or third parties to all the time maintain them, because this is creating always the unsafety of maybe closing operations or losing, let's say, the sense of strategy or direction that the community itself wants to go. We are proud that we have increased like the social and economic activity of the area. And this is like something that we try to work on and create a blueprint also with two universities to find out the exact positive impact that they had like in these two aspects. And it created more opportunities to the entrepreneurial scene in the neighborhood. The community, of course, like we had a lot of, because it was a highly tense political center, not center, but spot, let's say. So there were a lot of interests that they were from the left wings, the right wings, and we needed to create something neutral, that it has certain values, and it's inviting to everyone who respects those type of values. So as Vivian also was saying, like it's not for everyone, but it has a certain invitation with certain principles that the people that they feel connected or people that they want to get to know, they are they can come and they can visit, they can experience, they can co-experience something. So we have created this urban living room, as we say. We have managed to create like a collaboration between 17 different organizations that we work closely together in order to deliver this program. And we feel, and like the community feels, that it's a more safe neighborhood and there are more opportunities for employment and there are more opportunities for learning there. The points that I would like to raise, and maybe afterwards in the discussion about the cultural scene and the community space, is like, how do we maintain sustainable and resilient? How do we assess our impact? So, because we heard before also about gentrification or what's happening with the local communities, how do we create equal opportunities? So these are elements, the element of impact assessment is something that we focus a lot to clarify indicators and how these indicators, they can be met. And also the element of equity and loyalty of the community towards the project. The project of the municipal market of Kipseli, it had an open window of 5 years. So it's, the contract is finishing in 2022, in May. So we are going to see what is happening further down the line there. And it's important to see like how the different forces, how we can join forces, like the different organizations, but also with the municipality and the some private businesses, to see how we can work closer together in order to deliver more social value, let's say, out there. Yeah, that's all from me. Let me see some more numbers. And this is our website, Facebook and Instagram, that you can follow up with our work. Thank you.
Thank you, Dimitris. I think particularly the way you summed up the impact of the center of the market, and this is really impressive. And I think also the mixing of the social, the lifelong learning, and the creative hub concept, and also a market, the combination of that kind of formula to make it inclusive, but also specific as to what people want to use there and how should they connect with it, is really well thought through. So so lots to talk about in the roundup in a few minutes. So thank you very much for that.